huge hit again, number one hit for Alvin Jackson in the 90s. He wrote this one here. Well, if you're on a take a trip across the ocean, it would travel in a place and take a notion. I'll buy you tall, tall trees, all the waters in the seas. I'm a fool, fool, fool for you. Trip across the ocean, river travel in a place to take a look. I'm high as all the trees, all the waters and the seas. I'm a boo, boo, boo for you. Hey, I'm a boo, boo for you. It may take me time, but I'll prove it's true. Whatever's loving you want, and I've got it. And if it's money you need, I will get it. I'm high as all the trees, all the waters and the seas. I'm a boo, boo, boo for you. Big mansion, well I'll give it utmost attention. I'll buy you tall, tall trees, tall waters in the seas. I'm a boo, boo, boo for you. And if you wanna own a big limousine, I'll buy the longest one you've ever seen. I'll buy you tall, tall trees, tall waters in the seas. I'm a boo, boo, boo for you. It's true. Well, if it's loving you want, then I've got it. And if it's money you need, I'll go get it. I'll buy you tall, tall trees, all the waters in the seas. I'm a boo, boo, boo for you. I'll buy you tall, tall trees, all the waters in the seas. I'm a boo, boo, boo for you. Roger Miller. One of the best. Yeah, I tell you, he wrote a bunch of them. He wrote, last word and lonesome and it's me. He wrote that one. He wrote Invitation to Blues. That's What Happens When Two Worlds Collide. Lots of Eddie Arnold sang. Yeah. And of course he did this one. Trailers for sale or rent. Room split, if this is no fun, no pool, no pets. Ain't got no cigarettes, so but 2 hours of pushing through my house. Hey, my wife will be through. I'll be married by no means. King of the road. There's a boxcar, midnight train. Destination, don't pay no union dues. I smoke stogies that I have found. Short, but not too big around. I'm a man of means, by no means. King of the road. I know every engineer on every train. I'm the children.
Personal banding.
you know me so well.
I know you had a relationship with Mel Tillis.
Yes, sir. Oh, yeah, man.
Oh, go ahead and get a drink first. I see you.
I'm a little bit thirsty, little parts.
You ain't got a beer?
I'm going to take a break tonight, then we can go straight to it.
I got to take breaks sooner or later, don't I?
No, come on.
Let's keep going.
We'll get you some Jensen or something.
Get me something up there. Mel Tillis is so special to me. He's back in Florida. He was been in Nashville, not feeling so well. You know, 84 years old. But he's back. He's got his place in Ocala. He's back in Florida, which he's Florida boy, so he feels at home now, which is good. So any prayers, you know. Alice, are you going? You're doing Facebook, ain't you? Okay, so I say that because I figured you were doing that. He's doing better, but he's 84. He's very weak. But any prayers would be very appreciated. Mel Tillis managed me for over 10 years. It's hard to believe. And he opened up so many doors for me and made my life so much richer. It's amazing what I got to do because of Mel. And so I got to accept an award for him last April in Washington, D.C. for the Distinguished Artist Award. That was awesome, man. That was one of the coolest things I ever did. I got to go to the National Archives and the Rotunda there and sing right in front of the Declaration of Independence and Constitution. Yeah. You know, Jenny and I laughed because all I could think of is that movie, National Treasure. Yeah, I'm thinking about this silly Nicolas Cage movie. Oh, this is our National Treasures film. And now it was good. It was so cool. And I got to sing some Mel Tillis music. I'll give you a little bit of what I did that night. He came to Nashville in 1957 in a 1949 Mercury with a cracked windshield and $29 in his pocket, with a little baby named Pam in the backseat and his wife in the passenger seat. That same year he moved to town, he had Webb Pierce record a song that he wrote and went to number one for him. And it just kept going up and up about Tillis ever since then. He had this one, went to number one for Webb Pierce in 57. Clyde. you remember that movie, Every Which Way to Lose? This song went to number one. It was his greatest hit as a solo artist, according to the Billboard charts. Number one hit for Mel Tennyson in 79. You're just a Coca-Cola cowboy. They got a Eastwood smile and a Robert Redford hair. But you walked across my heart like it was Texas. And you taught me how to see, I just don't care. Here's a song Mel wrote. He always ends all his concerts with this one here. Bobby Bear took it to number one for him. I wanna go home. Those